Hello everybody, thank you all for tuning in. This is part 2 of the transmitter mode for the Eachine 018 that now bound to the Turnigy 9XR Pro. We're going to do a test flight, so we're going to see how good it flies now that we have better gimbals. And we're going to do a range test between these two to see which is best. And I'm going to show you some changes that we made to the radio, and it's going to be pretty quick. And it was, we changed the expo. I put the ailerons, elevator, and rudder at minus 60 to make it super responsive, and the thrust at 75%. Minus. You see? Instead of adding expo, we reduced the expo. So now it's super sharp. We only have to remove a little bit to get a whole balance of movement. So we don't have to use the whole sticks, because these sticks are pretty big to move all the way up and down and left and right. So I wanted to get that really close and very sensitive. The changes that we made, and we changed up the ends of the channels to change them up to 1500, centered them up perfectly. It shows up really bad on camera. Right here on top you can see. That's all. Let's go outside. Have some fun, because it stopped raining now, so, but it's windy. And now I'm gonna see how good she flies compared to the little tiny baby controller. I already did a flight test and a range test, and it flew farther away than 80 meters, but at that point I just can't see it anymore. And if you can't see it, then I can't fly it anymore. So for both radio controls I could fly 80 steps. That's, for me, that's 80 meters. You know, I'm 1.8 meters long. I'm from the Dutch, really long guy. So my steps are about plus minus 1 meter long. But we'll show you the difference between the flights. Because the thing that I was like disappointed of when you're using this radio with the multiprotocol module, so you have that rate button. You're missing the rate button to bump it up. And I thought like, oh my shit, this is not gonna fly as good as the other one gonna be.
Welcome to the Turnigy 9XR Pro.
But with this radio, you don't need the rate button as you have with the small controller to bump up the rates. The rates of this controller is a lot faster and a lot better than the baby controller. And I will show you that in flight. It doesn't even feel better on the sticks. You can fly a lot more precise. You can also fly very slow. But I can also fly very fast. It's already at the house. Time to come back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8. I like the way she flies. Let's do a range test. It's all the way there to the building. You see the angle is a lot more, a lot bigger than normal. So the rates are a lot faster. I can even so much forward that even at full gas it just comes down. Inside the house. Ooh. And now we are coming back. But and battery is gone. Where is it? Ah, there it is.
Yeah, we catch it again. So that's for the 90 Pro with the multi-protocol module. It's flying like crazy. And then double beep, so it's on high rates. And here's it leaning forward. But it just hasn't got the weight to get to the house. It's not even half to the house. And I'm leaning maximum forward. And when it full gas, it just goes up, 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 up. It just can't find the wind. Can't fight the wind. It's just not strong enough weight. I need more weights to fly. Well, it works perfect with the Turnigy 9XR. It's not more powerful than the other one. They are both exactly the same. Only the one from Banggood and the other one from Gearbest. But I'm missing the weight and I'm pushing maximum to the front and it's just not having it. It's just not capable to fly really outside. It's really for indoors. But as soon as you're having the Turnigy 9XR Pro with the Multiprotocol module, you have home a winner. And I'm turning this tiny Eachine E010 on a budget into a real good flying drone. Really good tiny drone. In my case, the best micro drone there is on a budget. And it's off. And that's on a half empty battery.